Now, the moment it got converted into a movie clip, notice in the properties panel a lot of things change. And here we have the option of display. And under the display, I have the blending mode. And I can choose screen because I want to remove the white. No, I should choose multiply rather, not screen. Because multiply treats white as invisible. And let's test the movie. The next thing is to deal with the logo. The fox part of the logo, we have managed to make the globe so far. We can, you know, keep on adding more things, and you know, we can also add an outline because the Firefox logo does have an outline. If you see the logo, see, it has an outline here. It has this blue outline here, and the color is not also, you know, very vibrant. The back is blue, while in our logo it's white. So we can, if you really want to make it look like this, then you need to drag it, and then we can, you know, pick out the colors from this logo and then apply it here in the background. Just for the reference, I'm using it, and we have a let's reduce the size of it. So we have a darker blue, so it seems as if the gradient is radial but shifted towards the bottom to simulate the light. Okay, and let's just switch off this layer for the time being, or let's just get rid of it. It's not, you know, we can make this thing separately on layer 5. So for the time being, let's just switch it off. And then on the background layer, we need to pick up a blue. Okay. Oh, sorry, 100% I want. Okay, this blue color here. So double click and we'll pick up this. And double click and we'll pick up this. Yep. Now we just need to change the position of this here and increase the size of it. Now more or less, I think we are doing a better job. So let's just, yeah, actually the color of the this thing is also not same here, and we can match it up, not an issue since we have the Photoshop open. So let's just match it up and open it in a separate document. I'll also drag this PNG file here because I'll be using this as a reference. This color we want here, so I'll control click on it to select all of it, then hold I on the keyboard to pick this color and then select this one. Say Alt plus backspace, Control D. Let's get rid of this layer, we don't want it, and I'll just press Control S on the keyboard to save it. Now we need to update it in Flash. And that we can do by going to library, find out that image, right click on it, and then choose update, and then say update. Done. Let's test the movie and then see how close we are. Okay, pretty much. Now this thing is bothering me, so I'll go to the gradient, lock the background for the time being, and let's just go back to the gradient where I have. I'll select the gradient and I'll remove these color stops. Let's have it very simple, like so. Okay, let's see. Let's go to the Photoshop, and we have that, you know, PSD file ready with us. So we'll just import it, and that we can do by going to Animate, File, import to Library, and select that PSD file. Now when we have a PSD file, Animate gives us option of importing all the layers or specific layers. Now in this case I just want layer 2, so I'll uncheck this layer 3 here, just import layer 2, and we'll be updating this PST file. In fact, we'll be doing additions to the PST file and import it back again. You will see just in a while why we are going to do that. Now I'll choose compression lossless. Okay, that's not important, but you know, if you really are a person who, you know, want things to be better for future, it's better to have a lossless compression. It compromises with the size of the file a little bit, makes it larger, makes it a little bigger, heavier. It compromises on the size of the file size. It certainly compromises on the file size a little bit, makes it heavier, but does give you the ability of republishing your work on multiple platforms without losing much of its quality. Okay, I'll say import, and I want to import it, I want to convert it into animate layers. So I'll say import. Now go back to library and then find out under the asset in the layer 2, you are going to have that fox. It will be utilized. Now I'll go inside the logo, because I want to do everything inside the logo. I just want a final movie clip which has all the animation going inside. So I'll go inside, make another layer on top of it, and we will call it fox. Okay, now I can select these four and put it in a folder. Okay, sorry, but let's just let it be there. We do not have, you know, that much complicated workspace here that we require arranging things in folder, but if you want, you can create a folder and put all these four files inside that folder. So on that fox layer, I'm going to import this fox. Okay, now I think we did a fair job in terms of selecting it. Okay, because the edges are very clean and smooth. Let's reduce the size of it, zoom out, click free transform, and reduce the size of it. Don't forget to hold shift while doing it, otherwise you'll distort the logo. Now what I want here, as this globe moves, I also want some effect on the fox, and for doing it I have an image which I have downloaded from internet, and I'm going to apply this reflection on the fox. So the idea here is, let's just import it, and you can also import assets in Flask by dragging it and just dropping it, but I'm not going to drop it on the fox layer, so I'll just cancel it out. I'll create another layer on top and I'll call it shine, and here I'm going to import that, drag and place it on top. The idea here is to move this shine through the fox, and I want to constrain it only within the fox. It shouldn't affect the globe. Okay, that's the idea here. Plus, let's change the background. If I go to scene 1 and change the background color to something different, then again it's not looking nice, you know. If the glow is going to revolve like this, it's not going to look nice. So I want to limit this reflection, this shine within the fox. So I can do it by using mask, and I need a mask which is exactly the same as the fox. So now what I can do, I can create a black silhouette of the fox in Photoshop, and then import it in Flask, convert that into a vector object, and use that as a mask to hide the unwanted areas of the shine layer. And I'm going to exactly do the same, and I'll show you how it's done. So I'll go to Photoshop. I still have that file open, and I can control click on it. I'm going to control click on the mask, all right, and create a new layer and fill it up with black. The black is the background color here, so I say control plus backspace, control D. It completely hides the fox. All right, fine. Now I'm going to use this layer. Now see, if I Notice, because I have, okay, let's see how it did. I think it's going to do just fine. So I'll save this PSD file, go back to Flask and import that PSD file once again. Import to library. And this time I'm only going to select this layer. Same, I'll go for lossless and I want it to be imported as animate layer. Into a movie clip by hitting F8 and we'll call it shine. It's a very good habit to rename all your movie clips and then say okay. The next thing is putting motion tween on it. I'll right click and then choose motion tween. Now I'll move its position from here to here. Now it's a rectilinear. Oh sorry, I need to do it on the last frame, then only the movement will be recorded. So it's moving like this. All right, okay. And if I switch on the mask, then it goes like this, but I don't want it like this. I want it to follow along the body of the fox. So I'll unlock it and I can click here in the center and drag it to curve it like so. Okay, the path, and I want it here. I can fix this, taking it here. Now it's time to refine the tween, and that we can do by right clicking on it and then choosing refine tween, or just double click on it. We need to add a curve point here, so we'll click here, add anchor point on graph, and then click on the center. Now I can move this anchor point. Okay, and we can find those anchor points here and calibrate it further to adjust our animation. So I want the shine effect to start from there, follow along the body of it. All right, okay. If I switch off, lock this layer, the mask will be effective, and see how the shine is traveling through the body of the fox. Okay. Now, as it approaches to the tail of the fox, I want it to become smaller. So I'll go to the last frame, unlock this layer first, and make it smaller. Hold shift for constraining the proportion. Lock it and then see it in effect. Yes. And I want it slightly bigger than it is when it comes some around here. So I'll unlock this and resize it. Make it bigger. Lock and then test the movie. Slightly smaller than this, it's too big. Hold shift. In fact, you know, I want it to start smaller, it grows bigger, so I'll make it small here. So it starts smaller, grows a little, and then again shrinks back to its original size as it goes. Today, let's test the movie and then see the result. All right, seems okay to me. We can definitely calibrate it as much as we want, the speed of the animation, the transitions, but here I want to, you know, give it a little fade. So I'm going to select it first frame and I'll go for color effects, choose alpha. Now for reaching to this alpha tab, make sure that you have first clicked on here. If you click here, it's going to select the motion tween span and you won't find that alpha effect here. So the next thing is to click on the movie clip, which gives us the properties of the movie clip. And then from this color effects style menu, choose alpha, and we'll drop it down to 60% and test the movie, then see. Okay, I want it to go out, the center point of the reflection go out here, so that can be very easily done by going to the graph and selecting this anchor point here, here, and then pulling it down. Yes. All right. So the most of the thing is done here. It's just about adding. I'll just remove this reference. We don't want it anymore. Maybe for creating this reflection. So let's just try to imitate that reflection which we have here, and it's just a gradient. A white round object is created there on the top. So on top of this gradient layer, if I add this gradient, you will lose this effect here. Maybe let's calibrate this gradient a little more. I'll lock the fox layer as well and lock everything on this gradient layer. We'll double click, go inside the gradient, and then let's make it 100, test the movie. Okay, still it is not affecting. Move this color stop and set the alpha to 100, test the movie. Okay, it's looking darker in these regions here. Okay, let's pull it here. This is how I want it to look. Okay. Fine. Now let's go back to the logo. We need to add up that shine here. So on top of the gradient, we'll make another layer and glow highlight. Okay. And let's just make a circle here. It remembers the last properties, that's why we are going getting this weird effect here. I'll get rid of the outline, and we want a linear gradient actually, and we'll also rotate the gradient. We want white tunnel. First let's see this shape we are trying to achieve. Fine. Now we just need to get rid of this black thing here. So the gradient is already applied. I'll say F8 to convert this into a movie clip, and then change the blend mode to screen for getting rid of that black, and I'll apply some alpha. Okay, maybe more. Yes. Okay, you can also drag up this for having less of white. See if you want more black. Movie, yes, we have that effect here exactly how we wanted it. Yes, we have pretty much accomplished what we wanted to. I'll get rid of this logo, and all of this animation is inside this logo, so I can place it anywhere. In fact, I can make a copy of it also. See. And we'll just beautify the composition, fit it to the window, and next thing is I'll apply a gradient on the background. Now I'll change it back to white, and on the background layer I'm going to create a rectangle. Now it remembers the last fill and outline setting, that is why we are getting this weird thing. every time we make a new object. So I'll change this gradient to a linear one, a radial one. See, and maybe this black, turn it into a dark gray. That's the movie. Gives more emphasis to the logo, and we will reduce the size of it also to have some more negative space in the composition. And hold shift, don't forget to hold shift, because you'll distort the logo otherwise. Now if I want to create a reflection or a shadow, I can go for that. I'll just push it up a little in the composition, and on the background layer I can make another layer and call it shadow. Now you can create this shadow layer inside the logo as well, because shadow is of course going to move with the logo, but I am just doing it here. I'll make an oval, get rid of the outline, fill it completely with black, and convert this into a movie clip. Say okay, I'll just rename it to shadow, and then I'm going to apply a filter blur. Choose the quality high and increase it to get this effect. It appears as if the logo is levitating in there. Fine. So here we have the final version of the Firefox logo animation for you all. This white line is very irritating, and I think we can solve it by increasing the size of the gradient we applied at the background. Just let it bleed out of the space, and that's gone. So thank you very much for watching the video. I hope you have learned a few things in this, and I would expect you to really capitalize further on the techniques and tools I have showed you in this tutorial, and come up with best of your own version of the logo animations. Thank you so much. I have also included the source file along with the assets I have used for this logo animation, and you can find that in the link below. And just do me a small favor, hit subscribe. Thank you.